Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, lifted up in the cross by your free will, Christ God, grant mercy to the commonwealth that bears your name. Glad our faithful rulers by your power, giving them victory over their adversaries. May your alliance be for them a weapon for peace and an invincible standard. Now and ever to the age of ages. Amen. Also, in unfailing protection, do not spare the supplications, gracious and all praise to the Orthros. Uphold the Orthodox commonwealth, preserve those who have called you, and grant them victory from on high. For you, the only blessed one, give birth to God.
Righteousness. the will of all those endeavors to Mary, with all of the saints, and ourselves, and others, and our whole life to Christ our God.
To you, O Lord.
All glory, honor, and worship are you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and always and forever and ever.
Amen. God is the Lord and has revealed himself to us. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Give thanks to the Lord and call upon his holy name. God is the Lord and has revealed himself to us. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. All the Gentiles surrounded me, but I fought them back in the Lord's name. God is the Lord and has revealed himself to us. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. This came about through the Lord, and it is wonderful in our eyes. God is the Lord and has revealed himself to us. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. By your cross, O Lord, you destroy death. To the thief you open paradise. The myrrh-bearer sorrow you transformed into joy. prior to bearing, and in bearing a virgin, and after bearing still a virgin. O life, you rose from the sepulcher, even though the tomb was secured with the seal of Christ God. Then, although the doors were shut, you came to your disciples, O resurrection of all. Through them you renew a right spirit in us according to your great mercy. Glory to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And here's the women bearing sweet spices went in haste to your sepulcher. And they were saying to each other, who will roll away the stone for us? For you, the King of all, were guarded by soldiers. The angel of great counsel has risen. After trembling on death, O Lord Almighty, glory to you. Both now and ever to the ages and the ages, amen. Rejoice, maiden, full of grace, O Virgin Theotokos, the haven and protection. Are you for all of mankind? For you did the Redeemer of the world become incarnate. Only you are both a mother and a virgin, O Lady ever blessed and ever filled with glory. Intercede with Christ God, beseeching him to grant peace to the universe. Of all the tree in the garden stripped us naked, and by its days did the enemy bring in death. Now the tree of the cross, which for all mankind is bearing the garment of life, was planted upon the earth, and therefore is all the world filled with every joy. As we see it revered today, let us, O peoples, cry aloud together unto God in faith. Full of glory is your house, O Lord. Glory to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever to the ages of ages. Of old, the tree in the garden stripped the snake, and by its taste did the enemy bring in death. Now the tree of the cross, which for all mankind is bearing the garment of life, was planted upon the earth, and therefore is all the world filled with every joy. As we see it revered today, let us, O peoples, cry aloud together unto God in faith. Full of glory is your house, O Lord.
And in peace let us pray to God, O Lord.
Kyrie eleison.
Help us, save us, have mercy upon us, and keep us, O God, in your grace. Remembering our most holy, the everlasting, glorious Lady, that thou taught us in the Virgin Mary, with all of the saints,
blessed be thou to us and by us,
and our whole life through Christ our God.
To you, O Lord.
For blessed is your name, and glorified is your kingdom, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen. In the flesh, you took our form and endured the cross. Save me by your resurrection, Christ our God, as the only loving one. O Savior, you delivered Zion held captive by error. Raise me also from the servitude of my passions and grant me life. He who sows sorrow in the south and fasts with tears shall bountifully reap nourishment everlasting. Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and to the prophets are joined in exaltation. The Savior has come, saying to those of faith, come into the resurrection. Today the infernal below trembled before one of the Trinity, as did Hades and death. The earth shook, and the gatekeepers of Hades were seized with fear when they saw you. All of creation, along with the prophets, joyously sing an ode of victory to our God and Redeemer, who has now destroyed the power of death. Let us shout and cry out to Adam and his descendants. The cross brought Adam in. Come to the resurrection. Fiery sword no longer guards the gate of Eden, for the wood of the cross has extinguished it in a most unusual manner. The sting of death and the victory of Hades have been destroyed. You came, my Savior, crying out to those in paradise, enter again into paradise.
Enter again into paradise.
Pilate set up three crosses on Golgotha, two for the thieves and one for the giver of life. When Hades saw this, it cried to those below, O my ministers and my powers, who has driven a nail into my heart? Suddenly my side has been pierced with a wooden spear, and I am torn apart. My insides hurt, and my stomach and senses are in pain. My spirit trembles, and I am obliged to cast out Adam and his descendants. They were given me by a tree, because of the tree of the cross, they shall enter again into paradise.
They shall enter again into paradise.
On this, the 22nd day of the month, we commemorate the holy Hiram Martyr Basil, presbyter of the Church of Ancyra. On this day, we also commemorate the holy women martyrs, Kalinike and Basilisa, who died by the sword. On this day, we also commemorate St. Drosilos, the daughter of Emperor Trajan, and the five consecrated virgins with her. The holy new martyr, Euthymios, who contested in Constantinople in the year 1814, died by the sword. On this day, the third Sunday of Lent, we commemorate the veneration of the precious and life-giving cross. Let all the earth adore the cross, through which it learned to adore you with the word. Through their holy intercessions, O God, have mercy on us and save us. Amen. That most holy, godly prophet Moses prefigured your cross in the Red Sea of old, O Savior, for he divided the water with a rod in his hand and led Israel across, and he sang a sacred ode of Exodus, O Christ our God. O Christ, set me firmly on the rock of the faith by the power of your all-holy cross, so that my mind will not move when tempted by the enemy's assaults. Only you are holy, O Lord. Almighty Lord, when the sun beheld you hanging on the cross, the great luminary shuddered, retracted and hid in its grace, and all creation fearfully sang a hymn extolling your forbearance. Indeed, the earth has been filled with your praise, O God. We rise early and we extol you, for through your cross we found peace that passes all understanding. Through it you, the Savior of the world, renew the human race, leading us unto the unsetting light. as he was blessing Christ our God unto the ages.
Was born in iniquities and
create in me, O God, renew a steadfast spirit in my breast. Cast me not away from your face, take not your blessed spirit out of me. Restore to me the joy of your salvation, and let your guiding spirit dwell in me. I will teach you ways to the sinner, and the wicked shall return to you. Deliver me from blood guilt, O God, my saving God, and my tongue will joyfully sing your justice. O Lord, you will open my lips, and my mouth shall declare your praise. Had you desired sacrifice, I would have offered it, but you will not be satisfied with whole burnt offerings. Sacrifice to God is a contrite spirit, a crushed and humbled heart God will not despise. In your kindness, O Lord, be bountiful to Zion, may the walls of Jerusalem be restored. Then will you delight in proper oblation and sacrifice and whole burnt offerings. Then shall they offer calves upon your altar and have mercy on me, O God. Glory to the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. O giver of life, open the doors of repentance to me, for my spirit goes to your holy temple early, bearing a holy defiled temple of the body. But as compassionate, cleansed by the loving kindness of your mercy, now and always and forever and ever. Amen. O Theotokos, guide me in the paths of salvation, for I have defiled my soul with shameful sins. I have wasted my life in indolence. By your intercessions, deliver me from every uncleanness. O God, have mercy upon me in the greatness of your love, in the abundance of your tender mercies, wipe out my offense, as I realize the arriving uncondemned at the bride.
Instructed us. Thank you.
unity of God's holy churches, and for the oneness of them all, let us pray to the Lord.
Yeah. Because of this, he is bound to offer sacrifice for his own sins as well as those of the people. And one does not take the honor upon himself, but he is called by God, just as Aaron was. So also Christ did not exalt himself to be made a high priest, but was anointed by him who said to him, Thou art my son, today I have begotten thee. And he also says in another place, Thou art a priest forever, after the order of Melchizedek.
He speaks to you, our leader.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
With strong eyes, let us hear the Holy Gospel. Peace be to God.
And to your spirit.
The Holy Gospel is according to St. Mark. Let us be
to begotten of the Father before all ages, light of light, true God of true God, begotten, not created, of one essence with the Father, through whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary and became man. He was crucified for us under Pontius Pilate and suffered and was buried. And he rose on the third day according to the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. And he will come again with glory to judge the living and the dead. His kingdom shall have no end. And in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the Creator of life, who proceeds from the Father, who together with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who spoke through the prophets. In one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the age to come. Amen.
Let us stand well.
Of God the Father, and the good.
thus became the first fruit of those who have fallen asleep, the firstborn from the dead, that in everything he might be preeminent. Ascending into heaven, he was enthroned at the right hand of your majesty on high, whence he shall come to render to each of us according to our deeds. But he left us remembrances of his holy and saving passion, these which we have set forth as he has commanded. For as he was about to go forth to his voluntary and eternally memorable and life-giving death, on the night when he gave himself up for the life of the world, and taking bread in his holy and spotless hands, and presenting it to you, God and Father, he gave thanks, blessed it, sanctified it, and broke it. And he gave it to his holy disciples and apostles, saying,
that's right. forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
spotless sacrifice, do not accept the yoke of sin ever willingly crucified for us, who are broken but not divided, eaten yet never consumed, sanctifying those who partake. In remembrance of your willing passion and your life-giving resurrection on the third day, proclaim to us partakers of the ineffable, heavenly, and awesome mysteries of your sacred body and precious blood. Keep your servants, ministers, those in civil authority, our armed forces, and the people assembled here in your sanctification. Grant that in every hour and time we may recall your righteousness, that we may be led to your will, and practice that which is pleasing to you, and thus be made worthy to sit at your right hand on the day when you shall come to judge the living and the dead. Strengthen our brothers who are in confinement, visit those who are ailing, guide those who travel upon stormy seas, and to those who have departed in the hope of life eternal, grant them rest for the light of your countenance keeps watch. Hearken to all those who beseech your help, for you are the giver of all that is good. O God, Almighty, Lord of heaven and earth, and of all creation, visible and invisible, in your ineffable goodness look upon your people who have gathered in your name. Be our help and defender in this day of affliction. You know our weakness. You hear our cry of repentance and contrition of heart. O Lord, who loves mankind, deliver us from the impending threat of the coronavirus. Send your angel to watch over us and protect us. Grant health and recovery to those who are suffering from this virus. Guide the hands of physicians and preserve those who are healthy, that we may continue to serve you in peace and glorify your most honored and majestic name. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen. Eternal Magnificat, Omnipotens, Omnipotens, Omnipotens. Blessed is the name of the Lord, both now and to the ages.
Thank you. Message of the cross. he underlined and he mentioned the fact that we are a faith of love, a faith of God's love, which is a perfect love that we're called to look upon and to imitate. We're also a faith of mercy. Mercy is love in action. It's taking that love and showing it to one another. But we are also a faith of hope. And when I say hope, I don't mean fanciful imaginings and things that we would like to see come about. But it's something that is proven. It's something that's based in reality. Something that we've experienced and cannot deny. And that is the reason that we have hope. We have all this as a hallmarks of our faith, but even more than that, we are a faith of victory. And that's what the message of the cross reminds us. And that's where the message of the cross comes in and can be a help to us, especially during this time. It's coming in a time when it's easy for us, especially sitting at home, to feel like we're defeated, that there's no hope. And the cross reminds us that Christ has conquered the agent of our separation, that of death itself. He conquered the cause of all of our separation from God. And if that fear of death is annihilated, then we have absolutely nothing to fear. The fear of everything else can be wiped out as well. And there's a beautiful message in St. Paul's epistle to the Romans. He says, yet in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am persuaded that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor coronavirus, nor stay-at-home orders, nor any created thing shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. And that's what the church reminds us of this day, and that's why it gives us the Holy Cross. Christ is the victor over the death, so therefore, he can be the victor over the coronavirus as well. So I pray that those of you who are at home, take time to venerate your cross, find a cross somewhere in your home, kneel before it, and venerate it for the great power that it has. Hopefully, almost all of you are wearing cross around your neck. And if you are, grab a hold of it and give thanks to God that you have been counted worthy to wear that cross around your neck and say, Lord, have mercy on all of us. And then patiently wait until all of this is over, because it will be over. In the meantime, I pray that as everybody is waiting for things to return back to the old normal, and may they never stay at the new normal, I pray that everyone is going to reach out and to be able to show mercy. Our love in action, the epistle reading that I just quoted from, mentions God's love, which is ultimately active in our hope and in our faith. So we have to imitate that love in our action towards one another, to everyone, and look for opportunities to reach out and to serve others. This is a new time for each and every one of us. And it gives us the freedom to be creative in thinking about how we can minister to everybody's needs. If you need mercy, please call and ask for help from anyone. There are people that are waiting in this parish to reach out and to serve you. I pray that God is going to bless and keep everyone safe, and he's going to bring us all back together with one another here again very soon. The next service that we have is tomorrow evening, Great Compline. And if you didn't see the bulletin that I emailed out this morning, our services on Wednesday and Friday are going to be at 6 p.m. We hold them a little later to make sure that anybody coming back from work doesn't miss them. That's not as much of an issue right now. So we're going to be at 6 o'clock, and hopefully that is a comfortable time for everyone. This Wednesday, we're not going to have pre-sanctified liturgy. If you notice, I didn't bless you with the body and blood of Christ that we would use for a pre-sanctified liturgy. That's because this Wednesday is the Feast of the Annunciation, the true feast of freedom, and it's also Greek Independence Day. But in honor of the Annunciation, we will have a divine liturgy in the morning, which you're welcome to click on and to watch at 9 with Orthros at 8 a.m. and Divine Liturgy at 9 on Wednesday morning. In the evening, we will not have a pre-sanctified liturgy. I pray that everyone will be blessed and will stay well and take care of yourselves. Please do minister to one another and also reach out so that everybody else can minister to you as well. Let us pray to the Lord.
Give me a nice one. Father, give the blessing.
May the blessings of the Lord and his mercy come upon us through his divine grace and love, always, now, and forevermore.
Amen.
Glory to you, Christ our God, and our hope. Glory to you. May Christ our true God, who rose from the dead through the prayers of his most dear and holy mother, the power of the precious and life-giving cross, the protection of the honorable Bible, the powers of heaven, through the intercessions of the holy, glorious prophet and forerunner John the Baptist, of the holy, glorious and praise from the apostles, of the holy, glorious and victorious martyrs, especially the great martyr Barbara, our patron saint, of our holy God-bearing mothers and fathers that show forth in asceticism, of Basil the priest martyr, whose memory we keep today, and of all the saints. Have mercy on us and save us, for he is good and loves mankind. Through the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy upon us and save us.
Amen.
Amen. May the blessings of the Holy Trinity be with each and every one of us always. I would like to thank, even though the church is missing all of you, it is full of your prayers and of your presence. And I would like to thank the few that are here, for Randy for coming and chanting today, and for Carlos, who is recording this and broadcasting it to you, and our parish council president that is here just in case. And I'd also like to thank you, Anili's family, for the beautiful donation of the daffodils that are placed around the tray here today so that we can honor this feast appropriately. Again, most importantly, thank you all for tuning in and being here. And those of you who are in Sunday school, stay tuned and go ahead and click on the link for the Sunday school Zoom class. We'll be starting in just a moment. And I will see you again very, very soon. God bless and keep us all. Amen.